There's a famous saying that I've seen which seems related to this video. Roughly paraphrased, it goes like this. I love hard work. I could watch it all day. So, if that sounds like you, this is a great video for you to watch. Seriously, I moved and now I have a lawn to mow. That's why I got this 5-blade push reel lawnmower from American Lawn Mower Company. It was a surprisingly controversial purchase. See, the problem is that I have a large lawn to mow. The total property area is roughly 2/3 of an acre. That's a little over a quarter of a hectare, for those of you not using freedom units. The point is that half of that is just grass. Lots and lots of grass. When I told people of my idea to mow this lawn with a manual push mower, many thought I was nuts. This surprised me as I read the Amazon listing. One of the questions that was asked was if 3/4 of an acre could be handled with this lawnmower. The response from the manufacturer said 0.75 of an acre can be handled by the American Lawn Mower. So this seemed like a great idea to me. It was only $120, which was way cheaper than many of the alternatives. Plus, this push mower is advertised as low maintenance. Nice. Now, daring to get political for just a moment, I think the hysteria over climate change is overblown. It's used more as a political weapon rather than genuine concern about the future of humanity and the planet. What's so bad about carbon? Trees love carbon. Just plant more trees. Yet, despite having that viewpoint, I don't like gas mowers. They're messy, they're noisy, they're smelly, they're loud, they don't always start right away. And let's be real, gas is getting very expensive. I didn't want that hassle. Now, the obvious alternative is to use an electric mower. Unfortunately, I don't like that idea either. While electric mowers can be much quieter than gas mowers, and electric mowers can have lower maintenance, going electric has its own set of problems. The main issue is the battery. That adds significant expense, and it limits how long you can work. Also, there's the issue of electronic waste. What if I don't store the battery properly over the winter? The following spring, I basically have a hazardous brick that needs recycling. And even if I maintain an electric lawnmower perfectly, the battery will still degrade. Of course, an alternative there is to use a corded mower, but this yard seems too big for that idea. So that's why I found this push mower to be appealing. Sure, it meant a lot more work, but I looked at that as exercise. As comparison, I have this treadmill, which is double the cost of the push mower. But I barely use the treadmill these days. That's because it's boring. After 5 to 10 minutes, I get tired, so I see little motivation to keep going. With mowing the lawn, there's no avoiding it. If a lawn is not consistently maintained, it can grow into a mess. What you see here in this video footage is my first outing with the American Lawn Mower 18-inch manual reel mower. It's a larger one, so that's certainly something to consider. I've been pushing the mower up and down the yard. Yet, they're not 18-inch wide tracks. Some overlap is needed. Otherwise, if there's space between the cuts, strips of uncut grass are left behind. That's why I'm happy I went with the bigger model. This meant less walking around. But let's get real. Is this manual reel mower a good tool for maintaining a large lawn? Well, I don't think so. It feels like the wrong tool for the job. While I think it's great for smaller lawns, big yards are a lot of work. While it technically can do it, wow, it's difficult. If you're an astute viewer, you probably noticed that this video is almost 15 minutes long. But that's not how long it took to cut the grass. Not on the first try. Actually, it was around 4 hours. It was horrible. I needed several breaks, and I was very tired. Then I needed a day of rest to recover. My wrists didn't feel great either. There was a slight pain, as moving the mower is a quite repetitive motion. On the second outing, It was much quicker, only taking 3 hours. I don't think I can get it much quicker than that. This raises the obvious question, can you run with it? So, I tried it. I was able to run with the mower, but this just made me more tired. I don't recommend it, as it is fairly dangerous. That's because, for this mower to work well, there are some requirements. The first is that the grass has to be fairly short. The recommendation is up to 4 inches. That's not a lot. I have seen it cut grass longer than that, but I've also seen it just flatten the tall grass instead of cutting it. This is a big problem with the mower, as I still needed something else to handle trimming the edges, like the tall grass along the side of the fence. So I picked up a cordless electric trimmer. Are you interested in a review of that product? You can leave a comment to let me know. But getting back to the second requirement for the push mower, it's only meant to cut grass. If something tougher gets caught in the blades, it stops dead in its tracks. This part is very important, as it's the biggest issue in using this machine. At one point, I almost fell over the thing. Which reminds me, I think that the handle could be longer. I'm over 6 feet tall, so even the larger push mower just felt small to me. So if you run over a twig, which can be quite common, that's a bit dangerous. That's exactly why I don't recommend running with this push mower. I'm starting to sound like one of those lifeguards at a community pool. Walk, walk. That's why my first outing with the push mower was so tough. Wood chips are the mortal enemy of this device. It's so demotivating to see such a tiny piece of debris just stop the metallic mower. But it is a pretty cool piece of technology. Here's some slow motion footage of the mower chopping up the grass. I really like that feature. Collecting and bagging grass is such a chore. All that extra plastic is not great for the environment either. That's what's really surprising to me. In New York City, garbage collection is handled by the Department of Sanitation. But in many other places, that's not a public service. A private company has to be hired for garbage pickup, and they may charge by the bag. So, not having to collect the clippings can be a financial savings, and apparently, it's good for the grass. I saw articles on the Colorado State University website, the University of Idaho website, and the Oregon State University website, explaining how it can actually be good to leave the grass clippings on the lawn and to mow more frequently. I think that's a match for the push mower, as it works better with shorter grass. What's really interesting is what I read on Connecticut's official state website. I mean, come on, the word cut is in the state's name, so they should know about cutting grass. It says, did you know that a half-acre lawn in New England produces over 3 tons, or nearly 260 bags of grass clippings each year? Think of all the time, money, and effort it would take to bag all those clippings. Why go through all that hassle when it's really not necessary? If you're curious about this information, links to all of the articles are in the description, because I'm certainly no lawn expert. The idea of me using this push mower originates with Conan the Barbarian. Specifically, it's the Wheel of Pain. Would I get stronger if I kept pushing the mower? Well, I could feel my heart pounding while using this machine. It looks so simple, yet it's very intense. That's because constant strength needs to be applied to keep the mower moving. That's why the second attempt was a lot faster. I tried to minimize the amount of turns. Long straight lines made the work a lot quicker, as the blades only spin when the mower is pushed forward. Speaking of pushing, it is somewhat tougher to push this mower uphill. Although I can angle the handle so that I can just lean into the mower, so it's not all bad. It's a good thing this is not a pole mower. That seems like it would be way more difficult. So, even though this is low-tech, with no electronics or electricity of any kind, I was quite amazed to see it work. It really does cut the grass. Here it is again, in slow motion. The blades of grass are being sliced and thrown about. That's another reason why I don't recommend running with this push mower. When I moved faster, the grass would be thrown higher. I was getting covered in grass. It's better to cut the grass when it's not so wet. If the grass is slippery and sticky, that's not ideal. Here's what my boots looked like after mowing. While this push mower is lower maintenance, it's still a bit of a dirty job. The weather is also a factor. I tried to cut the grass in the morning, starting around 8 a.m. If it's cloudy, that's even better, as I don't want to burn in the sunlight. Bugs are a problem too, as I got very sweaty. I used bug spray to ward them off, but it seemed to wear off after all the sweating, so I needed to reapply my defenses. Also worth noting is the assembly. You'll need a bit of strength to put it together. The bottom part of the handle needs to be bent to attach it to the lawnmower. That was difficult. Another problem with assembly were the bolts. One of them just wouldn't go through the holes. So only 3 out of 4 were attached. Also, one of the upper 2 bolts fell out. I don't know where it went. Hopefully I find it again. While I like the idea of toolless assembly, this was not a good experience. The bolts didn't feel snug. If I do keep using this push mower, I'll probably put on my own bolts. Meanwhile, can you hear the sound of the lawnmower working? It's obviously not quiet. Yet, I'm told it can't be heard from inside the house when the windows are closed. So, that's nice. Have you ever had a meeting or phone call interrupted by a loud lawnmower? That wasn't a problem for me here. Instead of plugging your ears with earmuffs, you might want to listen to music instead. With a smaller-sized yard, this could be a great routine. You could listen to your favorite podcast while getting yard work done. One thing I noticed is that this lawnmower is an attention grabber. People are curious about this retro machine, as its use is not common these days, not where I'm at. The American Lawn Mower Company was founded in 1895, yet this technology still has a purpose today. Anyway, that's the story. If you've been thinking about buying this push reel lawnmower, overall, I like it. I just think it's important to realize that it's better suited for smaller yards and without any major obstacles in the way. But wow, I certainly do appreciate having a lawn. The open space creates a quiet area, which makes it much easier to sleep at night. And the exhaustion of cutting the lawn for hours also helps with creating a deep sleep. Thanks for watching.